Every time I think of beans, I can't help but think of the playground rhyme. Beans, beans, good for the heart. The more you eat, the more you... Well, you know, they may cause a bit of gas, but they are good eating, produce high yields, and are really easy to grow. At the end of this video, I will let you in on a little secret that will double your production. There are lots of different kinds of beans, and I've described some of them in this blog post. In this video, I will focus on the string bean, which is also called the snap bean or green bean. When it's yellow, it's called the wax bean. They come in two growth habits, bush and pole. The bush beans make short plants, mature earlier, and all of the crop is ready for harvest at the same time. This is great for farmers who only want to harvest once, and it's a good choice if you want to preserve your beans. But it's not ideal for people who want to eat them fresh. For fresh eating, I recommend the pole bean. Takes up less space in the garden, produces more beans, and produces them over a much longer period so that you can pick a few every day. Both bush and pole are grown the same way, but you might want to give the bush beans a little more space between plants. Kentucky Wonder is a well-known heirloom that produces well and is easy to find in seed packs. It is available in both a green and a yellow bean. Blue Lake is also a popular green bean. The other cultivar I would suggest is the Scarlet Runner bean. It has nice red flowers and makes a bean pod that most people in North America have not eaten before, making it kind of special. Try a few vines in the flower garden and see if you like the flavor. If you don't like the way they taste, at least you've got pretty flowers in your garden. Beans are warm growers and are usually sown direct outside once temperatures reach 75 degrees Fahrenheit or 22 centigrade. Warmer soil works even better. If the soil is too cold, the seed will rot. You can also start them inside 4 to 6 weeks early and plant outside once the soil is warm. They don't like to be transplanted, so do this with minimal disturbance. Plant seeds with the eye of the bean pointing down, about an inch deep. This is where the root will emerge. Both seeds and seedlings can be planted about 4 inches apart in a sunny spot. The problem with beans is that the seedlings are very attractive to small animals and insects, and I find that the first few leaves get eaten if they're sown directly in the garden. They will recover, but it does delay harvesting. Starting indoors to produce larger plants works well. You can also cover the newly planted seed with floating row cover to keep hungry things away from the plants until they are about a foot tall. After that, they can fend for themselves. The reason these beans are called pole beans is that they like to climb. Traditionally, gardeners took several poles and made a type of teepee out of them. They would then plant a couple of seeds at the base of each pole. This works quite well, but I find it takes up a lot of room in the garden. I prefer to plant at the base of a trellis or chain-link fence and let them climb it. Ideally, this structure is about 7 feet tall, so the plants have lots of space to climb and you can still reach the beans. But shorter structures also work. Once you see the flowers, beans will soon follow. Give the plant lots of water and the beans develop quickly. The key to producing good fresh beans is to pick them at the right time. If they are too small, they won't have good flavor yet. But once they develop to the point where you can see the seed bulge in the pod, you've waited too long to pick them. This is especially true for runner beans. Pick before you see the bean seeds develop. As the pods get bigger, they get woodier and develop a string along the edge. You can still eat them, but they're now past their prime. The secret here is to pick every 2 or 3 days. Select the ones that are just right and enjoy them. If I miss a few and they start getting woody, I pull them off so the plant keeps producing more flowers and beans. Once the plant produces beans, it will keep producing until it gets either too hot or too cold. In zone 5, they produce until frost, but in warmer climates, they stop producing pods when the temperature gets above 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Beans don't have a lot of pests once they are out of the seedling stage, but the Mexican bean beetle can be a problem. It is copper-colored with black spots. Knock them in the soapy water when you see them. You can also use insecticidal soap. Aphids are also attracted to beans, and they come in a variety of colors. They like to live on the tender growing tips of the plants, where they suck out the juices. A heavy daily spray of water from your hose will knock most of them off and control them. There are many other kinds of beans you can try. If you are a beginner, try the above mentioned green ones. They are the easiest to grow, but most beans are fairly easy, so feel free to try others that you might like. Here's some suggestions. Lima beans tend to produce all of their crop at one time, so you can plant either bush or pole, doesn't really matter. The bush type mature sooner, so it is a good idea to plant new seed every 2 weeks so that you can harvest over a long season. Yard-long beans are popular in Asian cuisines. They produce very long beans and are fun to grow. The vines are also much longer than the green beans and can reach 12 feet. They grow best up a very thin pole since they have trouble wrapping around thick poles. Instead of harvesting fresh beans, you can also let the beans reach full size on the vine, let them dry, and then harvest as dry beans. Personally, I feel you can buy lots of dry beans in the store, but it can be hard to find really fresh green ones, so I focus my garden on producing things I can't easily buy. If you are after dry beans, there are many types to try, and they all grow about the same way. Here's the secret I promised you. I grow my beans up a vertical trellis, which is orientated north to south so both sides get sun. Since beans are warm growers, the trellis would normally sit empty most of the early spring, which is a waste of space. So what I do is plant snap pea vines on one side very early in spring. They will be about 2 feet tall by the time the soil is warm enough to plant beans on the other side of the trellis. The pea harvest is just about done by the time the beans start producing fruit. This way I get two crops from the same trellis and I am harvesting something most of the summer. To see a list of the 10 best vegetables for new gardeners and a separate video on how to grow each one, click on the link in the top right hand corner. It'll take you to a whole bunch of videos that you'll just love. Have fun growing veg in the garden.